I had seen Monica for years. We go to the same church, and for years I'd see her on her lunch break or different times. And she's always this ephemeral woman that I see in the distance and I never have a chance to meet, and I always thought she was incredibly beautiful. And it was this kind of ghost that I would see from, so I didn't know who she was, what her name was. And it really bothered me because I wanted to meet her. And I even remember meeting her months before we started dating, and she was with a friend, and I never had a chance to say hi to her because she was kind of in the background. But I remember thinking, this, I just wanted to give her a hug so bad because she looked kind of sad that day. And then so finally, we had bumped into each other on a night off and kind of lost touch. And so finally, one day after Mass, actually, I saw her during Mass and I was just blown away. I maneuvered myself close to her as close as possible without being suspicious. And then after Mass, I kind of had to play my cards to meet her. I had to do a fake washing of the hands to kill a few minutes there while she talked to a friend. And finally, she was by herself. And I distinctly remember saying to myself, it's now or never. And I remember thinking, you know, there's that saying, fortune favors the bold, and unless you go for it, you'll never know. And I said, here goes. And I went over and I met her, and I felt like it was chemistry from the start.
He invited me to go out on the river with him on a paddleboard, and I said, oh, maybe. And he made a joke about having two paddleboards, and he always goes with his friends. And I was like, well, then how am I supposed to go with you? Because I don't have one. And then he kind of got all sheepish and was like, well, I mean, we could just go. And then I realized it was like a mini ask me on a date. So he gave me his number, and then we ended up going for coffee before and then out on the river.
6 months after meeting, we went to my friend who's here, his wedding. But actually, I asked her to that wedding on our second date. I said, do you want to go to Ireland with me? I mean, that's how sure I was. I remember first summer we met, I never wanted to spend a moment apart from her. Never did.
I don't know when I knew I wanted to marry him, but I knew when I knew it was going to be serious. And we had taken a trip up to Whistler, and we were in Whistler. We were with friends, and everyone had left. It was just me and him at the end. And I don't know, I just thought he had been so gracious to everyone, and just the way he was being with me, and I just turned to him out of nowhere. I was just like, oh, I love you. And I don't know where it came from, but that's when I knew I really liked him.
I feel like I've won the wife lottery. I really do. I couldn't imagine anyone prettier, more special, anyone who matters more to me, anyone who has more character, more integrity. She blows me away.
I'm so excited. I thought I'd be nervous or I don't know, but I'm really, really excited. I'm really jittery. I feel like a little kid at Christmas, so really excited.
I, Philip, take you, Monica, to be my wife. I promise to be faithful to you in good times and in bad, in sickness and in health, to love you and to honor you all the days of my life.
You're all I, Monica, take you, Philip, to be my husband. I promise to be faithful to you, in good times and in bad, in sickness and in health, to love you and to honor you all the days of my life.
This love grows no matter where we go. You make me feel at home. We have known this world in times apart.
Monica, receive this ring as a sign of my love and fidelity. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Philip, receive this ring as a sign of my love and fidelity. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
There's no better place than to stay right where we are. And I'm holding on to make it last. Tomorrow always comes too fast. I never wanted any other way. Somewhere outside Atlanta, and I think my 12-seat band is right there out of frame. This was before I knew my way around Los Angeles, before I ever cared about nice neighborhoods. We were driving through the night, sleeping on hotel floors, and thinking that we had it good. We were kids back then, thinking we would live forever. We were kids back then. We were wild and free, taking on the world together. We were kids back then. That's how we're always gonna be. Closest blood. If we sat down for a drink, I think we'd forget all the stupid reasons we lost touch. It was just because we were kids back then, thinking we would live forever. We were kids back then, you and me. We were wild and free, taking on the world together. We were kids back then. That's how we're always gonna be.
lean in to take a picture when it hits me. In 20 years, I will look back and say, we were kids back then, thinking we would live forever. We were kids.